All right, what's going on, buddy? So Dan from Stockability, I want to make a short video to talk about what I'm seeing from the market heading into the election, kind of what my anticipation is, talk about a few things, and give some insights, some things that I'm waiting on in the market. So we just did our show Take Stock with Sam Evans, which is my business partner, every Friday at noon Eastern. And we were kind of talking about a few things. I got a few questions, so I'm going to expand on them in this video and talk about a few things here. So one of the things that gets missed a lot, and I'm just going to start here and talk about this on any market. So whether you're trading equities, forex, futures, it doesn't matter. You've got to take a glance at what the overall picture is on large time frames. So the Nasdaq right now has just been vertical, right? And I'm not saying it can't continue to be vertical. Obviously, this is an uptrend. But typically what happens is you get these pullbacks in markets. So right now, heading into the election, I find it super hard to believe that the markets are going to rally. It's just the odds are so slim, and I'll explain to you why as I go through these. So that being said, I want to be risk off. So when I say risk off, what that means is, again, if you're managing portfolios, again, not day trading. If some of you are watching day trading videos, this isn't day trading. When I say risk off, what I'm really saying is I want to be careful of risk assets, so equities, etc. I either want to be short the market through equities options, or I want to switch exposure to, let's say, a commodity ETF. So for example, risk off in commodity ETFs. I'm long UNG, which is natural gas. For the winter. So I'm looking at that as a potential play. I have a position in the equity shares on there. So when you start to look at the market from this perspective, I don't care what equity or stock you're going to buy. You have to be careful and look at it and say, what's going to happen ahead of time, and what's the overall market doing? If the Nasdaq has a signal, and again, if you're not familiar with candles, Sam has a great video on our, and I'll show you at the end of the site, a great 7-set videos. It'll talk about the basics of trading versus investing, and you can learn to kind of why candles are important. But this weekly and daily or monthly are not necessarily the most bullish candles. So again, I don't want to try to buy new positions into this election on the long side. I want to be risk off. I want to look at different asset classes, and I want to look at potentially being short. So you're getting a little bit of bid on this, and on the small time frame, it looks great. I'm not saying there's something wrong with this. And this could trade back up into 11,000s. But overall, right now, even if I'm going to scalp the range, and what I mean by that is, even on these lows, I'm not looking to establish long-term longs. These are probably day trades or short-term trades. So what happens is you can trade it from this level into the range, back off the range, back and forth. And that's typically what the market's looking to do right now. The other reason I think we're headed lower into this election are bonds really haven't done much, okay? So on a very basic level, bonds are kind of setting up for what I would consider, let me just go to a weekly here real quickly, potential move higher. So these have been pretty much dead for all summer long, and it makes sense, but this has the potential above 167.50s to trade higher. So I'm really curious to see what that wants to do in that particular asset class as well. So additionally, if you look across the board, if I take a look at, like, let's say for Zoom, for example, a lot of equities have just been vertical, right? And these type of scenarios don't last, right? When equities go vertical, right, you're not going to continue to see that go unchecked. And what I mean by that is, let me delete some of this, is you're not going to see, a straight vertical climb like you saw in August through what was the option buying from SoftBank. So again, right now you're getting a lot of short-term trades. You're not getting a lot of new trend-based situations. And what I mean by that is when equities are pulling back, they're rallying, they're pulling back. They're rallying, they're pulling back. I mean, if we just take a look at a short-term time frame on literally Shopify here, you get these days where it's trading down 40 points, it's back up 20 points, it's down 40. Like, you're getting such a gyration in price action that it's hard to stay short, it's hard to stay long. It basically shifts this entire environment to a day trading, or basically a two-day hold environment, which what a lot of this is. Now, I think based on what I was discussing on the Nasdaq, as well as the SPY, right, if I look at this on a monthly time frame, the S&P 500, I think based on this, that this has got to de-risk more. I think you've got large pressure selling on the large time frame, and I think you've got to come back into this election. So I don't think it's a rally into the election. I think it's a pullback into the election. So I'm looking at different asset classes and trying to position certain trades short. So that's just kind of an insight to it there. I am long natural gas. I talked about it briefly. I'll talk about it in a different video. As the trade starts to progress, I'll talk about my position, give you guys some insights, why I like natural gas as an ETF, why I'm putting this particular trade on, and then kind of talk you through it so you can get some insight to it. So that being said, let me go to this video or this insight I was telling you about on the website. If you go to stockability.com, Sam's got this great, if you click this here, it'll take you to 7 videos. I highly, highly suggest watching this. I know we live in the day and age where everybody likes 30-second videos and our attention spans aren't that big. But I go through this, right? This is a free 7-section video. If you're new to trading, if you haven't done this, watch this. I promise you, he does an extremely great job explaining a lot about what this does. Sign up for that. It's free. Just literally watch it. We're not even going to take your email address. Just go through and take a look at it. Additionally, you can get access to a free starter session. So if you want to learn more about this, take the time. We've got some dates coming up on this. See what it's about. I popped in the last one this week for an hour, talked about some option positions I had. I think you'll highly enjoy it. So that being said, I just wanted to put that out there to kind of put a caution out into the election to, again, be careful, take a look at the market from the overhead, and just understand that this is a big time to take into consideration the risk in the market that's going to be present, because there will be large moves coming the next 4 to 6 weeks in the markets. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for following. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel below.